Good morning everyone. Today we will discuss about taxonomy and taxonomical hierarchy. In the previous lesson, I told you about classification, the importance of classification. As I told you that the India is considered as a mega biodiversity nation. A number of plant species and animal species are found in our country. And to study all the plants and animals as well as microorganisms, we need to classify them so we can study all these plants, animals and other living organisms in a systematic way, in the proper way. And to study the living organisms, Carolus Linnaeus, he put forward binomial nomenclature in which the plant as well as the animals, each plant and animal has two names, genus and species, and the scientific name is universally acceptable. It is specific for the plant and animals. Today, especially you will see that how the different rankings have been made to study the living world in a systematic way. There is a term, first of all, taxonomy. What do you mean by taxonomy? Taxonomy is the science of the study of the living organisms in which we identify the organism, we classify them, and we give their names also. So taxonomy is the branch of science which deals with the study of identification, classification as well as nomenclature. I have already discussed about the systematics, and almost systematics definition is same as the taxonomy. But is there any difference in taxonomy and systematics? The systematics is the science of the study of the living organisms in which we identify, classify them, nomenclature, as well as there is a detailed description also. Especially in systematics, we classify the living organisms on the basis of their evolutionary history. We correlate them, the different species of the plants and animals, that how they have been evolved and what are the similarities and dissimilarities regarding the evolution. So apart from identification, classification and nomenclature, systematics also includes the evolutionary pattern, the evolutionary history of the living organisms. The taxonomy, you can say, is the branch of the systematics. This is a very broad area, systematics, and taxonomy, it comes into this systematics. These two terms are also important. Taxon. What do you mean by taxon? Taxon, it belongs to the ranking of an organism. When we classify the plants, either animals, we use different rank. We divide them into the different groups and subgroups. And these rankings are called taxon. For example, as you know, all the human beings, they come into the class mammalia. So we are mammals, and mammals is the taxon. The frogs, they come into the class amphibia. Amphibia is the taxon. Some of the animals, they are reptiles. So reptilia is the taxon. The plant, plantae, or animalia. Plantae, as you know, it is the kingdom, and plantae includes all the plants, means the plantae is the taxon. Animalia is the taxon. Now, the categories. When we rank all these living organisms, we set them in a framework. This framework is called taxonomical hierarchy. You can see different ranks or different categories are given for the living things. Like species is the category, genus is the category, family, order, class, phylum, kingdom, all these are the category. So rank or level of organization, each rank in the taxonomical hierarchy is called category. For example, species, genus, class, order, these all are the categories. Now let us start with the taxonomical hierarchy. What do you mean by taxonomical hierarchy? Taxonomical hierarchy is the study of plants, animals, and other living organisms into a successive order by assigning them into the different categories. These sequence may be in the ascending order, that is from species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, kingdom, in this order, or maybe in the decreasing order, like kingdom, phylum, class, like this also. But generally we follow from bottom and we go up to the top. And this is the taxonomical hierarchy. A series, a chain of the different categories, it makes the taxonomical hierarchy. You can see here, first of all, species. What do you mean by species? Species is the individuals of the same kind, of the same population. And all these individuals of the same kind, they can share the gene pool. They can interbreed among themselves. And this is the definition of species. The same kind of the individuals of a population is called species. I am giving a few examples. For example, Mangifera indica.
This is the scientific name of which plant? Mango plant. Solanum tuberosum. This is the scientific name of potato. And Panthera leo. This is the scientific name of tiger. Now you can see here, indica is the species of the mango plant. Tuberosum is the species of Solanum. And leo is the species of Panthera. Indica, tuberosum and leo, these all are the species. The scientific name of the mango is Mangifera indica. Mango is mango. Dasahari, Langra, Alfonso. Whatsoever the varieties are to be there of the mango, but overall, all the mango plant, their scientific name is Mangifera indica. They belong to a particular species that is called indica. I am not talking about the variety, but their scientific name is Mangifera indica, and indica is the species. All the variety of the potatoes, they belong to the species that is tuberosum. So, species is the individuals of almost same type of a particular population. Now, the second hierarchy, second level is genus. What do you mean by genus? The genus, the same kind of, almost, or you can say the closely related species, they are grouped together into the genus. In a very simple way, you can say that the group of the species, almost same kind, this is called genus. You can see here the example. Here I have written two scientific names, Solanum tuberosum. This is the scientific name of the potato. And Solanum melongena. This is the scientific name of the brinjal. The potato and brinjal, their species are different. You can see here, the potato, their species is tuberosum, and the species name of the brinjal is melongena. But because of some similarities in brinjal and potato, their genus name is same. That's why in both of the cases you can see here, Solanum, I have written Solanum tuberosum and Solanum melongena. The because of the common similarity, some of the closeness, the genus has not been changed and the genus is same. Now the next level, that is family. What is family? The closely related genus is called family. For here three genus are there, Solanum, Petunia and Dhatura. These all are the different genus. Solanum, Petunia and Dhatura. But because of the some common characteristics, few characteristics, because of the close relations between all these three genus, their family is same. And that family is Solanaceae. So the closely related genus, it forms family. Now, the group of family or the closely related family, makes an order. For example, in plants, here I have written two families, that is Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae. And these two families still have some common features. That's why these two families have been kept into an order, that is polymonials. The same like here in the animals, the two families are there, Felidae and Coniceidae, and these two are kept into the order, and this is Carnivora. Now, the next level, and here the Panthera and Felis, both they have been kept into the Felidae. Now, next to the order, that is class. The closely related orders. This one is the family, Felidae. It goes like this. Felis and Panthera, both are included into the family Felidae. Now, the class, the closely related orders makes a class. For example, here two orders are there, Carnivora. And Carnivora, it includes, for example, tiger, cat, dogs. These all are belong from an order, that is Carnivora. And Primata, it consists of monkey, gorilla, gibbon, and human beings. They all belong from the order Primata. But because of the some similarity in Carnivora and Primata, in these two orders, both the orders have been kept into the class, that is Mammalia. On the basis of the mammary gland, in the tiger also, in the tiger, cat, dogs, all they are having, in the female, they are having the mammary glands. All they have the external ear, that is pinna. And here also in monkeys, gorilla, given human beings, all they are having the mammary glands, the female. And the external ears, that is pinna. And because of these characteristics, these two orders have been kept into the class, that is Mammalia. Now, the group of the class is called Phylum. The closely related classes makes a phylum. These phylums are for example, Chordata, Non-Chordata, these are the phylum. Phylum Chordata includes all these classes, Piscis, it includes all the fishes, Amphibia, like frog, salamander, etc., Reptilia, Avid, Mammalia, these all are the classes. And because of some common characteristics in all these classes, all these classes have been kept into the phylum, that is Chordata. Can you tell me that what may be the common characteristics in Piscis, Amphibia, Reptilia, Avid, Mammalia? These are the different classes, but why all these classes they have been kept into a phylum, that is Chordata? Because of the presence of vertebral column. Because of the presence of backbone, the bones, vertebral column, all these classes, they have been kept into the phylum Chordata. Now, next level, in the plants, we use the term division for the phylum. I have not written here, But in class 9, you have already, in class 9, you have already studied about thallophyta, bryophyta, pteridophyta, gymnosperm, and angiosperms. All these all are the divisions. So phylum is used for the animals and division is used for the plants. Now the next and the top level of the level, or the you can say the category, is kingdom. And kingdom is of two types, plantae and animalia. Plantae includes all the plants like algae, bryophyte, pteridophyte, gymnosperm, angiosperm, all the plants, because they all are plants and they have been kept into a kingdom, and that is plantae. And the same like all the animals, they have been kept into the kingdom Animalia. So that's all for the taxonomical hierarchy. It's very, very important. And you have to make this diagram, this sequence, this order from bottom to the top. That is species, genus, family, order, class, phylum is a division or kingdom. And it is included in this heading, that is taxonomical hierarchy. I am giving you some other examples. Now, I have written here few examples based on the taxonomical category. These are the taxonomical categories: species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, kingdom. Few examples are there. These examples are given in your textbook, and all these examples you will note down in your fair copy also, and you will revise, you will learn it. Common name, human. The scientific name of the human is Homo sapiens. Our scientific name is Homo sapiens. The sapiens is the species. Homo is the genus. Human beings belongs to the family Hominidae. Hominidae. The order is Primata. The class is Mammalia. The phylum is Chordata. And the kingdom, we belong to the kingdom, that is Animalia. So this is the classification of the human beings. You can classify yourself, that what is your scientific name, what is the name of your species, what is the genus name, what is your family, what is your order, what is your class, phylum, kingdom. It means not only the human beings, other animals also, the plants, they have been classified into a proper framework scientifically. And being a student of biology, you are supposed to learn at least the scientific name of the plants and animals present in your surrounding, in your nearby places, and also you try to classify them as per this taxonomical hierarchy. Dog, the scientific name of the dog is Canis familiaris. The species is Familiaris and the genus is Canis. The family is, the dog family is Canidae. Order, Carnivora, as it is carnivorous, that's why the order is Carnivora. The class is mammals, Mammalia, like the human being, because the mammary gland is present in the dog also, in human dog.
ears are there, that's why their class is same. Chordata, because of the presence of the vertebral column, the phylum is same, and definitely the kingdom is Animalia. It belongs to the kingdom animals. These two examples I have written for the plants also. You can see mango plant. As I told you, the scientific name of the mango is Mangifera indica. Indica is the species name. And Mangifera is the genus name. The family of the mango is Anacardiaceae. The order is Sapindales. The class is Dicotyledon. It is a dicot plant. That's why the class is Dicotyledon. And phylum is Angiospermae. It is a flowering plant. Angiospermic plant. That's why the phylum is Angiospermae. And the kingdom is Plantae. Overall, it is plant. That's why the kingdom. There are only two kingdoms, Animalia and Plantae. It is included into the kingdom Plantae. Now, the last one is the wheat. The scientific name of the wheat is Triticum aestivum. The aestivum is the species name. Triticum is the genus name. The family is Poaceae. The order is Poales. It is a monocot plant. That's why the class is Monocotyledonae. And phylum is Angiospermae. And kingdom is Plantae. So that's all about the taxonomical category, the hierarchy of the taxonomical category, taxonomy, and you have studied today that how the living organisms like plants and animals, they have been classified into the taxonomical categories in this hierarchy in the different you can say the rank in this framework. Now you please note down some questions as the assignment and you will complete the same. Question number one. What is taxonomy? What is taxonomy? Write its importance. What is taxonomy? Write its importance. Second, differentiate between taxonomy. And differentiate between taxonomy and systematics. Differentiate between taxonomy and systematics. Next question. What do you mean by taxon? T-A-X-O-N. What do you mean by taxon and categories? C-A-T-E-G-O-R-I-E-S. What do you mean by taxon and categories? The next question. What do you mean by taxonomical hierarchy? Explain with the help of diagram. What do you mean by taxonomical hierarchy? Explain
with the help of diagram. The last question.
Write few examples of plant and animal. Write few examples of plant and animal. And write few examples of plant and animal. And on the basis of taxonomical categories. And on the basis of taxonomical categories. On the basis of the taxonomical, you have to write like this. You will take two examples of animals and two examples of the plants. But all these questions you have to do in your biology notebook. You make a separate notebook, as I told you earlier. So that's all for today. Tomorrow I will teach you the next topic. Thanks.